Oh my gosh. Just look at the fish bits getting coated and hugged and embraced by the creamy, thick sauce.
Fam, it's me, Bella, the Steak and Butter Gal. Today's video, you will see what I eat on a typical day. Today's menu is a bit different, but still one of my regular meals. And then I show you a cute little keto carnivore grocery haul for me and Steak and Butter Guy. And then we finish off with the spicy mayo covered poke. It's delicious and Steak and Butter Guy loves it. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the video. Let's get started. Alrighty guys, so I am preparing my meal first. This is 2 pounds of ribeye from Whole Foods, and I am using scissors to just cut it up into bite-sized chunks. Now at this moment, I am already heating up my pan slash pot, whatever you use, heat it up so it's sizzling hot so that it gives it a beautiful sear and so that you don't have to cook it for that long. Now this is actually inspired by the Carnotarian on Instagram, Linda. I love her Instagram and she gives me so much inspo. As you can see, it's in the pan. Heating up, sizzling up, getting a nice sear, and I literally keep it in here for no more than 30 seconds. It's just a quick sear. I like my steak raw. Oh, and egg pudding. Here's the finished product. As you can see, it is absolutely gorgeous with still very rare insides of the bite, if you know what I mean. And then let's see what's in here. Okay, so this is chicken drumsticks that I cooked up for Steak and Butter Guy. Now this is only a small portion of his meal. You'll see the keto poke recipe later. Simba here just smells all the aromas and scents of delicious meats and foods. The chicken I literally just chucked in and pressure cooked for about 25 minutes. And the seasoning in there is just some coconut amino, some salt, some pepper. Oh, and this is Simba's meal, just raw dehydrated Sojo's brand turkey formula. Alrighty guys, so here is the Whole Foods grocery haul. Everything here is from Whole Foods, even the scallions, and they're a little wilted because I kept them in the freezer and I took them out and it kind of melted. Okay, so first I got a bunch of raw fish, fresh wild caught always. This is wild caught king salmon. This one I got called swordfish. Now swordfish is great for poke and Steak and Butter Guy loves it. Here we have some ground beef. 80-20 guys is my ideal ratio. Anything fatter would be great, but I don't go any leaner than that. 80-20, $4.99 a pound at Whole Foods. It's amazing price for the amazing quality. And this is more king salmon. So we have swordfish and salmon for the poke recipe, which is coming up very shortly. And then I have some eggs. Now sadly, there were no Vital Farms eggs at all in stock, so I just went with the next best. This is soy-free pasture-raised, which is really cool. Oh wait, it's cage-free. Yeah, sometimes you just gotta go with the second choice. I got some raspberries for Steak and Butter Guy. He loves freezing these for like a frozen ice cream fruity snack. And then guess what I found? Duck eggs. Now I'm so excited to try duck eggs in my egg pudding recipe. It will be so exciting and I'll keep you guys posted how I like it. Here we have the fish that I got for the poke laid out, ready to be chopped up. This is the 2 pieces of, what is it? Wild caught swordfish, and they had wild caught today.
Whoa.
Isn't that awesome? And that everybody was trying to get it, but because I went in the morning, yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah. So I was like, can you just cut the pretty parts out? Yeah. So I got these two. Yeah.
I love you.
I love you so much. Wait. Look at the salmon. I just got a little bit because it wasn't too fatty and I just got the prettiest part. But this was actually wild caught on sale for $24.99 a pound, which is still crazy expensive. So I just got a little sliver of that. This was $14.99 a pound. Now, if you want to make sure that it's safe to eat raw, you should freeze it for about 20 to 30 minutes. Thaw it and then eat it. Okay, so let's cut into chunks. So I do know that Mr. Steak and Butter Guy likes bigger chunks, right? A little
yes.
bit bigger. How's the texture of swordfish? I've never tried swordfish like ever.
Yeah, it's very creamy.
It's creamy?
It dissolves, I feel like, very quickly. Which is really weird because swordfish, when cooked, it's like a very dry fish. You know?
Yeah.
And usually the proteins that melt in your mouth have a higher fat content.
Right.
I do feel like it dissolves pretty quickly. At least a lot more so than the tuna that we got.
Okay. Look at the beautiful skin, just how glossy and ombre that is. So I always fry up the salmon skin so it turns into a cute little salmon chip. You can always just give it to your dogs raw as well for some omega-3 fatty acid boost in their diet. I'll give this piece to Simba. There you go, guys. We have our beautiful poke raw fish bits ready to be marinated. Okay, now let me teach you guys how to make the spicy mayo sauce. So we have already chopped up scallions, also known as green onions. These are just Asian onions. We use this all the time in Asian cuisine, especially Chinese cuisine. So like that. I'm just adding in the sauces, as you can see. A dollop of mayo. Like that. And then you guys just mix it up. Whisk it however you like, with whatever utensil you like. Do it with your fingers, whatever you want, guys. Just do it until it becomes a nice creamy color, like so. I'm actually going to put the two pieces of fish in separate bowls. So this big one will be just for the swordfish. Like, oh, it's so satisfying to see. Oh my gosh. Just look at the fish bits getting coated and hugged and embraced by the creamy, thick sauce. Wow. ASMR. And now you close the lid. If you want to shake it up some more, you don't have to, but I would store it in the fridge and let it marinate and soak in the sauces and flavors for at least an hour. 40 minutes should be fine. And here I'm doing a separate bowl, same recipe for the salmon.
This little baby boy, ooh, you are ready to eat, huh? Good boy. Oh, look at his shiny coat. He's this beautiful because he eats raw carnivore, guys.
That's true.
Simba, sit. Good boy. Ready, Simba? Good boy. Wow! Blink if you love egg pudding. He loves egg pudding.
Okay guys, so here is our amazing meal of the day for Mr. and Mrs. SBG. Obviously, this is for Max. Swordfish raw keto poke with spicy mayo sauce, iced coffee. Of course, my good old egg pudding that is way too overcooked, but I don't mind. Some steak bits inspired by the amazing Linda or the Carnotarian. Some keto dessert for Max, Greek yogurt, honey, raspberries, and also for Max, 3 drumsticks. As you can see, lots of variety. But hey, it's all healthy.
Blink if you love egg pudding. He loves egg pudding. Okay guys, we'll see you guys in the next video. Say bye, Simba. Spin, Simba, spin. Spin! Do a little spin for SB Fam. Thank you. Good boy.